awesome.
The thing is, you got to wear your shoes, right?
Wear
on your feet, right? A lot of people buy shoes and don't wear them. Which brings me to my next point. Y'all see the box, right? It's an old Jordan box. Okay? Now, these are a pair of the white, black, and red, a.k.a. the Chicago Air Jordan 2s from 2004. And long story short, they haven't been worn in a while. So, they were worn recently, and that's what happens when you don't wear your shoes. Okay, pay attention.
They're talking to you.
Adults, you can see the Air Max.
Wow.
Oh, and they're coming apart as
yeah, they're crumbling, bro.
You gotta wear your shoes. Now, the day, let's go into story time. The day was March 27th, 2004, Tallahassee, Florida. Me and my boy Corey, cat who got the job at Finish Line. Shout out to you, Corey. Tampa, ATL, Charlie, yada, 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 all that good stuff. My dog, we used to wake up early. We had reservation slips. This is before the raffle and all that stuff.
Right.
This is their version of it. Right. They had slips. You put your name on. You cut it out. You had to be at the store by a certain time, 8 o'clock.
Yeah.
And I went to the store. Me and Corey went to our store. And we went and scooped these things up for $110. I think $117 after tax. And I made a promise to Corey that day. I was like, man, you know what? I ain't gonna wear these. Tallahassee is not gonna see me in these shoes.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I ended up wearing them 4 years later. You know, had them in a rotation. And then the last time I actually wore these shoes was in 2016. I had to go to the dentist. And I remember I said, you know, let me just put them on real quick. Yada, yada, yada.
Right.
Okay, cool. And 4 years later, they get worn again. And that happens. On this shoe, it's not as bad. But if you get close enough, you can see that. See, I even had to blow these things off. But you can even see where it's cracking.
Oh, snap.
Whoa. On the, yeah. Like, inspect them. Like,
I don't want to.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's crumbling at the bottom here.
And at so this part.
It's crumbling here, and then you can see a crack. Oh, it's cracking. Did you know
it's
cracking
cracked
right there,
too?
So yeah, there's cracks here and here. So if you want to speak on this, man. So, this shoe, only a certain person is going to have this shoe in their rotation.
Yeah.
Can you speak a little bit about the significance of this two for you? And
In particular, like I said, in addition to the story that
obviously value, that, yeah. But like the lineage of the Jordan brand, maybe talk about that and where Jordan 2 fits in there for you. Because a lot of people don't really.
Yeah, they kind of skip over the
thing,
especially this colorway, because it's only been retro to see a retro to 94, then a retro in 2004. And then it dropped again as another quick strike in 2010.
Right.
The difference with that one in 2010 was the back here. You see this back tab where it says Nike?
Right.
That was all red. Nike was in black.
These
are just like the original from 87 and 1984. Now, I remember in school days. Remember that movie?
Yeah.
Kadeem Hardison, you can see him actually cleaning with a toothbrush.
Okay.
And, you know, Kadeem Hardison is known, a.k.a. Dwayne Wayne.
Dwayne
is
Wayne.
Known for rocking all kinds of Jordans, OG stuff.
Yeah.
And, that's just with this particular shoe, though, man. Oh, that hurts to even look at it like that. Like, so, you know, I'm still going to keep these, obviously, just as mantelpieces.
Man.
But,
sure.
I mean, it just, it hurts when you don't wear a shoe for a long time.
And you want to bring it out.
You want to bring it out, and then it crumbles.
Yeah.
You see a lot of this with the polyurethane midsoles.
Right.
With the Air Jordan 2 through 9. Mm-hmm. After a while, that tends to happen.
I hope y'all soaking up this game right now. This is dropping mad facts for y'all. I just want to let him talk today, because this is
just, I got to kind of vent a little bit, because I'm hurt by this, man. Like, I mean, I can remember vividly going to the store, waiting in line. Well, I didn't have to wait in line. I'm sorry. I went through the front with the reservation slip. Gave it to my man, David Justice. Here's you. Get the shoe for $110. They even had the number on the box.
Yeah, I saw that. Pair. That's cool.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you definitely got to keep this piece. I mean, at this point.
This is, you know, when he won his first scoring title.
Yep.
Averaged 37.1 points a game in it. First dunk championship.
Yeah. I have the low version of these.
Yeah, the low from 2016.
Yeah.
So we had to get those two.
Yep.
And this was actually the first basketball sneaker ever to cost $100.
Yep.
Back in 2000.
And this was, they had the ostrich on it.
Yeah.
This was the luxury shoe they really wanted to use Italian
leather. It was from Italian leather.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Italian leather with the
So a lot of people hate on the two. I think it's an acquired taste, but I think if you're a collector, if you've been around the shoe game for a while, it's a staple shoe that you know, I won't say a must have, but
it doesn't hurt to have
if
it.
You know, you know, kind of like, right, yeah, you know, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, real, recognize real.
Isn't that what Pusha said? If you know, you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
Absolutely. But yeah, I just figured I would let y'all know. Tell me what y'all think. Y'all had similar situations with this? Even if it's this particular shoe, the 3, the 4, the 5, man, you know, it's you know, casualties of war when it comes to the shoe thing. You know what I mean? So it is what it is.
And then real quick, just so you probably, you may or may not know. So when you go to a sneaker store, or you might go and you see a collector that has their shoes wrapped in Saran wrap.
Yeah.
So
this is why.
This is why. Basically, when too much air hits the polyurethane over time, it becomes brittle
and weak. And the slightest bit of weight you put on it, just crumbles and turns into dust. Like, we've got dust all over the place. You might need to check your drink.
It's in my drink,
man.
Is it
in your drink, man?
Nah.
Oh, okay. It's not in your drink? All right. Well, obviously not. So, yeah. But
man, I had the great fives from 2006. And
same deal.
I was wearing those. And literally, as I'm walking, I felt just like...
You felt like extra cushion.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, this is cool. And then I look behind me and I see a trail of white, you know, polyurethane. So, and that, you know, so anything that's been in your closet, you know, just sitting there, you might want to check it.
Check it and check the firmness of the midsole. And just wear them, even if you wear them, you know, once a month.
Enjoy it, and
get some kind of wear
out. Or enjoy that last ride in them, man.
Right, I still remember my last ride at the dentist's office in these. You know what I mean? So, man, you know, talk to us. Let us know what y'all think. This happened to y'all. If not, great. And on that note,
and like, comment, subscribe. Absolutely. You know, crossover kicks. Real, recognize real, baby.
And we're going. Peace.